In the year of the turrets, a great host
needs something stranger.
Oh boy, here comes Coverass. Is he? Never mind.
No, excuse me, but I'm late for my classes.
Well, here he comes. I thought I might find you somewhere around here. Allow me to introduce myself. Please do. My name is Coverass. I used to work for your father, running messages to his Harper friends in Waterdeep. Before he passed on, he entrusted this ring to me and asked that I give it to you should evil ever befall him. Will you take it? Mint says, there's something funny about this man. I've never seen Boo's whiskers quiver so. And what evil befell him, Coverass? You were there. You saw it all. A woman, an armored figure, two ogres wielding clubs, and two archers. But Garion's petty magic was of no use against them, was it not? And you fled with your tail between your legs, hiding amidst the trees until dawn broke. And now it comes full circle, doesn't it? The Iron Throne so close that you can almost touch them and wreak your revenge for that night. He knows a lot for someone who supposedly wasn't there. You're right, Coverass. I was there. Myself, my father, and six others who tried to kill us. Where were you, if you know so much? If you be so void of trust, I am surprised you have made it this far. It is of little matter. Go seek your vengeance or your doom at the hands of the Iron Throne. I wash my hands of it. Whatever.
The Lord of Murder shall perish, but in his doom he shall spawn a score of mortal progeny. Chaos will be sown from their passage. So saith the wise Alondo.
Please shut up so I can talk to you. Sapphire, you look distressed. What is it, child? There is trouble here, Chanter. You must help me. You're right. I have felt it too. Pray tell me how this aging frame can help you. I must know who has visited the keep lately and where they have spent their time. There have been a few nameless scullery maids, some new watchers. As for visitors to the library, though, two men from the Iron Throne arrived. What was it, 2 days ago? Three? They're here for a meeting with two Knights of the Shield, who I believe made their arrival yesterday. Much of their time has been spent on the third floor, arranging preliminaries for the meeting. A man named Coverass has arrived as well, but he's mainly kept to himself, researching some of Alondo's prophecies regarding the Time of Troubles, which we keep on the second floor. Other than that, well, it's been only you. From the Chanter, I hear that two representatives of the Iron Throne are meeting with two Knights of the Shield. Who are the Knights of the Shield? On the third floor. Also, there was a stranger named Coverass who has been studying the prophecies of Alondo on the second floor. Odd that they should all arrive near the same time. Can't talk to him. I wanted to ask him about secret passages, but we only had a chance to ask one. A scroll of luck. So I already know that one. Still walking around. Checking for books.
No, excuse me, but I'm late for my classes.
Stop reading books, will you?
We should rest now. I need sleep.
History of the Dragon Coast, I've read that one. Mirror Image. Of the Dead 3. Still remember when we had to give that to Firebead Elven here, I believe? Or he gave that to us as a reward for the what we found for him. In any case, it's a really interesting read. Chromatic orb. And I think I checked this one. Ash is full. Chromatic orb. Well, I definitely have chromatic orb. You're not turning these bandit scalps. Actually glad only some of these have books, like as a functional bookshelf, and not all of them.
No, excuse me, but I'm late for my classes.
Yet you have a lot to say. Hey, I remember you. Your father was Gorion, wasn't it? You should see all the strange fellows who've come into the keep these days. Three men work for that mercantile organization. Iron Throne, I think they call it. They've been meeting with the two spookiest people I've ever seen. It's like clockwork. Every day they meet on the third floor to discuss who knows what kind of dastardly plots. Haha, I'm sure they're just boring old merchants counting their money. No, not really. One of the Candlekeep breeders told me that the Iron Throne leaders have been receiving mysterious visitors on the third floor. Alright, well, that's that room. Who the hell is this? A watcher. Oh, there, Watcher.
I should have joined the army.
Hol's gotta stop holding his mead fests. My head is killing me. He's not gonna be of much help then.
We should rest now. I need sleep.
No rest for you. You rest after this is done.
Excuse me, but I'm late for my classes.
Alright, I guess we're going up. Who's that?
Why me? These walls contain the world's knowledge.
Alright. More bookcases. Another scroll of luck. Shadowdale book.
Excuse me, but I'm late for my classes. Excuse me, but I'm late for my classes.
Just checking in case any of the other readers have anything interesting to say like that one did.
Excuse me, but I'm late for my classes.
You're all late for your classes. Every last one of you. This one gotta be different over on that side.
We should rest now. I need sleep.
Alright, that's all the books here in this section. Looks like we just go through there. This is luck, right? Yeah. Rieltar says, my dear sir, you must realize that it is manners that make the gentleman, so would you kindly prove that you are one by leaving? The right people can afford to be rude, but this is not you. Leave now before my irate companion Brunos lets his temper get ahead of his reason. Are you talking to him or to us? You're the leaders of the Iron Throne. We're the ones who've caused you so much trouble over the past weeks. We know what you're all about, and soon, so will Duke Eltan. And you're stupid enough to admit this? Well, my young friend, you may find safety within the library, but once you've left, there'll be no place for you to run. How about we just end all our problems right here and now? Draw steel, and let's sort everything out with the sharp of our blades. This is most distasteful. I have always known that rudeness is how the weak make themselves look strong. Even if you were somehow to beat us in battle, how would you escape the keep? Or did you think that the monks would let you go about murdering everyone within their keep? Bruno says, crash them mutton heads, boys. Oh, well, they are going to attack, okay.
Sure.
How about the fiend?
What?
Magic missile, that's what. Well, this is Tuth. We have a note from a Tuth.
Yep.
Interrupt. And Kestor. Okay. One Tuth dead. Well, that's not Tuth, that's a someone else. Oh, Rieltar is dead. Okay, cool. Cure medium wounds. I'm out of the other ones then, aren't I?
I don't want to talk.
your life, Submit. Yes? What is it?
It's almost dead. It's not worth it to paralyze him now. Although our friend needs a little help. Oh, we still got this person over here. Kestor.
Tempest, give us victory!
Oh, Minsk has got something going on. He's stunned. Waiting for the music to stop. We all survived, that's a good thing. Potion of Genius. Potion of Clarity. 510 gold, 256 gold, 98 gold, and 105 gold. Darts. Magic darts. A magical morning star. Potion of Frost Giant Strength. Oh, he's still stunned. Minsk is back. Okay. Take that. Minsk can have that. Morningstar plus one. Dart of Stunning. I still need these regular darts. One dart of stunning. Okay, then we also got magical chainmail and shield. Chainmail plus one, medium shield plus one. Well,
go pester someone else.
That was interesting.
All right.
We should rest now. I need sleep.
Well, apparently we're gonna be attacked when we leave here. I don't know if we can sleep in here. We'll try. What does he mean, just in general, as they wander through the land, kind of thing? Priest of Agma. Scroll of Identify. Well, that's it for that. Yep, yeah, we can't rest here.
I should have joined the army.
Sapphire, stay where you are. I do not wish to harm you, but you must come with me. You would be questioned regarding the murder of the Iron Throne leaders. They were apparently killed not an hour ago, and an item of yours was found with the bodies. Please, you will get a fair trial if you come quietly. I will use force if I must. All right, I surrender. Take me to Ulron to Tethril so I can prove my innocence. I'm glad to hear that. I did not wish to harm you. I'm sure this mess will be cleared up soon. Okay. Interesting. Oh, we're in prison now. Ulron is here. So, Sapphire, you have sullied your father's name by defiling his home and bringing ruin to a peace that has lasted for centuries. I spit on you and all of your friends. Your transgressions will be punished in the most severe form. I formally accuse you of the murders of Brunas Kostak and Rieltar Anchev. Wait, I thought I was going to prove my innocence. Someone really needs to give him a clue, Imuin says. But I have done nothing wrong. Why have you accused me of such a thing? You were seen fleeing the site of the murder by the guest known as Kavaras. Huh, that guy again. From everything we have seen and found, it is not hard to figure out what your purpose was. From what I've been told, you've been trying to place all the misfortune of the Sword Coast squarely on the shoulders of the Iron Throne. I assume you and your friends are assassins in the employ of Am. Perhaps you were sent up north to create discord in the region before Omnian invasion. It matters little. You and your friends are to be sent to Baldur's Gate, where an appropriate punishment will be administered. Now what? Oh, hello? Tethril. Huh. Hello, young one. I am sorry to see thee in such terrible circumstances. I know thee well enough to see that you have been falsely accused. Tomorrow, Ulrant will most likely sentence thee to be sent to Baldur's Gate. There, thou wouldst receive the death penalty for these actions. I know that Carion would not want to see his only child killed a scant few weeks after his own death. 'Tis as a favor to his memory that I will help thee escape. Make thy way through the catacombs beneath the library, but disturb them not. I have your possessions with me. You must take them and go with haste. But I want to explore the other floor. Do you know anyone by the name of Kavaras? I know of no one named Kavaras, but Kavaras is the reverse of Saravak. A young man who accompanied the leaders of the Iron Throne when they first came. I know not where he has gone. Well, that was probably him. He gave us a letter. Did you hear that? Imuin says. Saravak. Sounds kind of fishy to me, don't you think? It is now time for you to go, Sapphire. I can teleport you to the secret room that leads to the catacombs. From there, you are on your own. You must be careful within the catacombs, as there are many guardians and traps, and perhaps whoever planned these murders. However dangerous the catacombs may be, they are a safer alternative to Ulrant's wrath. Why can't you teleport us outside of Candlekeep? Candlekeep is protected by powerful runes that seal it from divinatory and alteration magics. If I were to transport you outside of Candlekeep, you would be ripped asunder when you came in contact with the protective field. Trust me, child, this is the only way. Yeah, I don't feel like being ripped asunder right now, I was just gonna say. My suspicions are true, then, Dainir says. Thou art of Baal's seed. Could be. You have advice for me, haven't you? 'Tis the same advice I ever give thee. Be wary, with but one difference. Be as wary of thyself as of others. Thy prophecy is a cold and dark one. What does it say? What is my destiny? The words I saw were few, yet chilling. Armies march and cities burn. The rivers froth with tainted blood. The corpses of those born not innocent feed the inferno of boiling heat. You scare me, down here. Is there more? I know no more than that. This door leads back to the upper levels of the keep. From the look of it, it is heavily warded. Luckily, Testeril has teleported you past such an obstacle. Common sense dictates that you make your escape through the opposite door. Alright. Well, we got more bookcases.
Why me?
Chromatic orb, confusion, and shadow door. That's interesting. Who's got identify? Level 5. By means of this spell, the wizard creates the illusion of a door. The illusion also permits the wizard to appear to step through this door and disappear. In reality, she has darted aside and can flee, totally invisible, as per the improved invisibility spell. For the spell's duration, a true seeing spell, a gem of seeing, or similar magical means can reveal the wizard. That's interesting. 9 rounds plus 1 round per level after 9th.
We should rest now. I need sleep.
I don't know if I can rest in here. Do I didn't sleep in that cell? Oh, we copied that one. Confusion. Yeah. You can't use that. 'Cause it's like an enchantment thing. Oh. Corian. Oh! Are you kidding me? Wait a second. This is what he just gave to us before he teleported us out of the jail cell. Hello, Sapphire. If you are reading this, it means I have met an untimely death. I would tell you not to grieve for me, but I feel much better thinking that you would. There are things I must tell you in this letter that I might have told you before. However, if my death came too soon, then I would never have been given the chance. First off, I am not your biological father, for that distinction lies with an entity known as Baal. Well, there we go. Of course, Dinah here kind of ruined it because she started telling us this stuff that she knew about it before we read the letter. The Baal that I speak of is the one you know of as a divinity. In the crisis known as the Time of Troubles, when the gods walked Faerûn, Baal was also forced into a mortal shell. He was somehow forewarned of the death that awaited him during this time. For reasons unknown to me, he sought out women of every race and forced himself upon them. Wonderful. Your mother was one of those women, and as you know, she died in childbirth. I had been her friend and, on occasion, lover. Isn't he very old, Garion? I feel obligated to raise you as my own. I have always thought of you as my child, and I hope you still think of me as your father. You're a special child. The blood of the gods runs through your veins. If you make use of our extensive library, you will find that our founder, Alondo, has many prophecies concerning the coming of the spawn of Baal. Yeah, we read a couple of them. There are many who will want to use you for their own purposes. One, a man who calls himself Saravak, is the worst danger. He has studied here at Candlekeep and thus knows a great deal about your history and who you are, Garion. Wow. That's... Wow, okay, that's the big reveal, then. We need to rest and get healed up and stuff. I don't know if we can rest in here. I say it's warded, so maybe no one can come through the other way. But we haven't checked out everything in here.
Something up?
Agonizar Scorcher and Lightning Bolt. I didn't mean to give it to her. Oh, wow. Fireball. Identify scroll. Sweet. Oh, they stacked. Awesome. We both know Fireball. Monster Summoning 2, I think. She actually has these. Yes. Awesome. Now we can stop complaining about how tired we are.
Why me?
Get out of here through the catacombs. Evil round any corner. Step. Evil round every corner. Careful not to. Eek! I think I just stepped in some.
All right.
Beware, my friends. Boo says nothing here is as it seems. Boo also warns that his keen nose tells him there are a lot of spiders and undead here, and by the smell of sulfur, plenty of explosive traps. Are you sure it's that, Boo, and not that piece of cheese you've been hoarding in your pouch for the last 10 days? Sorry, just checking. Hey, you big lug, tell Boo to stop warning Sapphire about the traps. A girl gotta earn a living too, you know. But Boo can never disarm a trap the way little Imuin does. You betcha. I know you can, Boo, but let's not upset our good friend Imuin by telling her that she hasn't yet come to terms with your greatness. Alright, well, traps, so...
Good job. Hello there.
Who's this? Flidia. My book! You stole my book, you cur!
Your time is done, primates!
Hurry up!